It's exactly 2 years ago today that the first case of COVID-19 was identified in Australia. Since then, we've had almost 1.9 million cases. And with numbers still high in New South Wales, all current restrictions have been extended for another month.
Of the many ways to describe 2 years of the COVID pandemic, this hits the mark.
I think we've been through hell and back along the way.
And it means we're no closer to total freedom. Current restrictions to stay in place for another month include masks in all indoor settings and QR codes compulsory in venues such as hospitality and retail. The one person per 2 square metre rule remains for pubs, clubs, restaurants, cafes and nightclubs. And no singing and dancing in a range of entertainment and hospitality venues except for weddings, performers, instructors and students. The Premier saying it's the prudent approach, and with waiting times for non-urgent elective surgery increasing in the past year, it may be the key to resuming operations by mid-next month.
If you were to ask what's more important, someone singing or dancing or someone getting their non-urgent elective surgery back, I know what the right approach is.
50% of schools in Sydney have now received their supply of rapid antigen tests and masks. Staff now arranging for parents to pick them up before next week. 5 to 11-year-olds only became eligible for COVID vaccines 3 weeks ago, so it's encouraging that almost 29% have now received their first dose, and pharmacists say demand is building. Certainly the case at Blooms the Chemist in Randwick.
Lots of parents are calling us wanting to get their children vaccinated, and I think parents and families are realising the importance of it.
Among them, twins Harper and Bailey Ryan.
I was talking to a group of friends yesterday, and all of the grandchildren are either have an appointment or have been vaccinated.
And for parents anxious about sending children to school, keeping them at home will be the exception, not the rule.
If there is a student with an underlying condition, if there's a parent with an underlying condition, we'll continue to work with you.
Also being worked through, delivering scarce, free, rapid tests to those who are eligible. Blooms Randwick, one of the few in the area with supply.
I'm really relieved.
There were another 18,512 positive cases, 2,943 people in hospital, 183 in ICU and 72 of those on ventilators. Another 29 people have died, 16 men and 13 women aged from their 60s to one person more than 100 years old. All this 2 years to the day since the first case of COVID-19 hit our shores.
I wouldn't be surprised if we had further confirmed cases.
But the World Health Organization's Europe chief believes Omicron could finally bring COVID-19 to an end in Europe. His boss disagrees.
It's dangerous to assume that Omicron will be the last variant or that we are in the end game. Globally, the conditions are ideal for more variants to emerge.
Eddie Meyer, Nine News.